Dr. Dina Hinshaw, the Chief Medical Officer of Health in Alberta, has come under fire recently for not enacting tough enough measures to protect Albertans from the pandemic. And there's a whole question about whether it should be her or the government, and I'll address that in a column later today. But right now we want to talk about what would an economist say to Dr. Hinshaw as she's considering tougher measures. To discuss that, we're going to talk to Dr. Lindsay Tedds, who's an economist at the University of Calgary. So welcome to the interview, Lindsay.
Thank you very much for having me.
Okay, simple question.
Yeah.
Dr. Hinshaw calls you up your office at the University of Calgary, says, Lindsay, I'm going to toughen up the measures around COVID-19 pandemic. What advice do you have to give me? What's your answer?
My advice directly to is, first and foremost, Alberta needs a much richer paid sick leave job protection. And that paid sick leave also needs to cover people who have to stay at home because of these restrictions. We have, the province of British Columbia had a really good program that rolled out that was specific to COVID-19. You need to support people to be able to stay home. Got to give them money to be able to do that so that they don't go out risking their lives and other people's lives because of the restrictions. And then just like we did what the federal government did in the first wave and what the province has not really stepped up to the plate in is providing income support for businesses that have to close in order to make this true. So, right now, I think Jason Kenney is presenting it as a trade-off. It's either everybody loses their livelihood to get the virus under control, or we try a little more personal responsibility and livelihoods are maintained. That's not the trade-off. That's a false trade-off, because we can, in fact, enact stricter measures and keep those businesses whole.
Now, one of the things that struck me as I've been listening to the premier roll out these measures over the last day or two, some of them just seem odd. So, for instance, Albertans can't socialize in their home with people outside their family unit, but they can go to casinos and eat in at restaurants. And it occurred to me, and we'll take the example of restaurants, why wouldn't you say, we're not going to let anybody eat inside the restaurant, but Albertans, we want to encourage you to take out, order takeout from all of the restaurants you would normally go to, leave a generous tip, let's support our restaurants that way. You put in an advertising campaign to support it, you make that a big, messaging point for government, and do it that way. And what do you think of that?
Well, yeah, I mean, absolutely. That's what we did back in the spring. We had curbside pickup and delivery. A lot of companies repurposed themselves as delivery. I think Men at Kilts, for example, came up as a company that pivoted very quickly. I think this issue is that unless you have support programs for the workers, because they're going to that model is going to have an impact on employees, then you absolutely need to have a much richer set of programs. But it's not like you need to put in a richer set of programs for a significant length of time. If we get this under control, right? And this is what a lot of the health experts in Alberta are saying right now. If we lock down 28 days, we're gonna come out of this much better in January than otherwise. And I think that's the real concern right now, is that we are sacrificing sort of a really good economic recovery starting in the new year, as we're hearing the vaccines being rolled out, to try to keep businesses open. But businesses will only stay open if the consumer confidence is there. And it is clear it is not there with these restrictions in place.
Well, yes, and that certainly seems to be the case. And what are the consequences of an overburdened and perhaps collapsing hospital system? This is what I hear from doctors that I've interviewed, is that the Alberta hospitals are, maybe a week or two away from simply being overwhelmed with new COVID-19 patients. That's got to have economic consequences.
Yeah, more so because we're also seeing a lot of the hospital staff having to isolate because they are being exposed to COVID-19 in ways that are just shocking, like people not responding truthfully to a question before they enter into the hospital. You know, if our hospitals get overwhelmed, we know what happens. We saw it in Italy. We know what happens when our hospitals get overwhelmed. And that from an economic perspective, if our hospitals get overwhelmed, consumer confidence is going to tank. Consumer confidence tanks, those businesses which they're trying to keep open are going to close anyway, and without government support as a result of the decisions that we're making right now to keep them open.
Well, this is a very difficult question, and we're trying to navigate through a thorny patch where we don't have any experience, and I really appreciate your insights, Dr. Tedds.
Well, thank you very much for having me.